Students, today we are going to discuss a special keyword in C++, the static keyword. So static is actually a storage class specifier. So this is actually a storage class specifier. Means it tells where the variable which has been declared static will be kept in the memory. Okay, so we have actually four kinds of storage class specifiers: auto, static, extern, and register. Okay, so the normal variables which we create in a program are by default auto variables, automatic variables. So storage class specifier means they tell us where the variable will be stored, what will be the variable's lifetime, and what will be the variable's scope. Okay, so if the variable is automatic variable, then the storage is non-permanent. Okay, it means the variable will be stored on a stack. Okay, so it will be available when you are in the function in which it is defined, and when you leave the function, the variable I stored on the stack will also be deleted. Okay, so this is the non-permanent storage. And the lifetime is within the block or the function in which the automatic variable is defined. And same is with the scope. Scope is also within the block or the function in which the variable is defined. Okay, so if you want to use int I outside this block, then the compiler will give you an error, because I is not available here, I is available only inside this block. Okay, then next we have static variables, the static keyword. Okay, so the static keyword means the variable which has been declared static will be stored on a permanent memory. Okay, so it means when you leave the function in which you created this variable I, even then the variable I will not be deleted from the memory. It will still be available. It will still hold its value there in the memory. Okay, so it means its lifetime is throughout the program. Okay, so it will keep alive. Its lifetime is throughout the program. And the scope is same as automatic variable, so it is available only within the function in which it is defined. So if you try to access it outside the function, it will not be available. Extern is the keyword which is used to define the global variables. The global variables are those variables which are accessible to all the functions. Okay, so the global variables are also stored on the permanent storage, and they are also available throughout the program, and their scope is also global. Okay, so they are accessible throughout the program and everywhere. And the last kind of variables are register variables. They are similar to the extern variables. They are similar to the automatic variables. This is automatic, non-permanent, within the function, lifetime and scope is also within the function. Register variables, they are similar to automatic variables. Their lifetime is also within the function in which they are defined. Their scope is also within the function in which they are defined. The only difference is that they are stored in registers. So we have basically two kinds of main memory. One is RAM and the other one is registers, okay, CPU registers. So whenever the CPU has to access some variable, so it contains some registers where it stores the data which it needs frequently, okay. And in the RAM, it stores data it does not need so frequently, okay. So access of the CPU to registers is faster as compared to access of RAM, okay. So if you want something that should be accessed faster, then you can declare those variables as register variables, okay. So this is the only difference between the automatic variables and the register variables, okay. So as I told you, the lifetime of static variables is throughout the program and the scope is limited to the block in which they are defined, okay. So before moving forward, let us create a program to understand the difference between the automatic and the automatic and the static variables, okay. So let us understand it with the help of a program. So in this program, we will write a function double get average double, okay. So the difference between automatic variables and static variables can be understood with the help of functions, how they behave during the function calls, okay. So that is why I have created a function here. I have declared this function. I will define this function after the main, okay. In the main, let us create some variables. Int data is equal to 1, comma, average, while So I have written this program. So now let us try to understand what this program is doing. So here I have declared a function double get average double. So this is the name of the function which is receiving a double parameter, and it will return a double value. Okay. And in the main function, what we have done, we have declared a variable data equal to 1 and another variable average. Okay. I think both of them should be double. Okay. And then we have a loop while data is not equal to 0. So we have declared, we have defined data intentionally equal to 1. Why? Because otherwise the while loop will not run. Okay. So while data is not equal to 0, data is 1. So this condition is true. Data is not equal to 0. So this loop will run. So it is prompting the user to enter a value. The user will enter some data. Suppose the user enters value 10. Okay. Then we are calling the getAverage function and passing this value data. Okay. And this value data is copied to variable d. Here we have two static variables, int total equal to 0 and count equal to 0. Both are 0. So when this function runs for the first time, both of them will be initialized to 0. Okay. And then count plus plus. Now count becomes 1. And total is equal to total plus d. Means total equal to 0 plus 10. That is 10. And return total divided by count. So total divided by count means 10 divided by 1 is equal to 10. So 10 will be returned. So the average is 10. But now the while loop is not terminated. While loop will run again because the data you entered is 10. So data is not equal to 0. So again it will prompt the user to enter a value. The user will enter another data. Suppose now the user enters 20. 20 will be passed to the function. But now what will happen? Static variables, as I told you, they are permanent. They are stored on a permanent storage. Okay. So even when you get out of the function, the variables will not be deleted from the memory. Okay, so this total will be there in the memory already. We will not assign the memory to it again. Okay, so what was the value of total in the previous function call? It was 10. So it will retain its value. Okay, similarly count in the previous function call, count was 1. So it will retain its value. It will not be defined again. It will not be allocated memory again and again. Okay. So the static variables are defined only once. Defined means they are allocated only once. Allocated memory only once. And they are allocated memory on the permanent storage. Therefore, they are able to retain their value throughout the function calls. But what happens with automatic variables? Automatic variables are not stored on permanent memory. They are stored on stack. Stack is not a permanent memory. Stack is created when you create a function, and stack item is deleted when you exit from that function. Okay. So every time you call a function, the automatic variables are defined again and again. It means they are allocated memory every time you are calling the function. So they are initialized every time you are calling the function. Okay. So now let us come back here. So static int total in the previous function call, it was 10. Count in the previous function call was 1. So these values will be retained. Then count plus plus, now it will become 2. And total equal to total plus d, that is 10 plus 20 equal to 30. So 30 will be the new value, and 30 divided by 2 is equal to 15 will be returned, and this value will be printed here. Okay. So again this while loop will run because data is not equal to 0, data is equal to 20. Again, it will prompt the user to enter a value. Suppose now the user enters the value 30. Okay, and average function is called. Now, in the previous function call, the total became 30 and count was 2. Okay, and now we do count plus plus, count becomes 3 and total is equal to total plus d. In the previous function call, total was 30. Then total 30 is equal to 30 plus now the total becomes 30 plus 30 equal to 60. Okay, and here what are we doing? Total divided by count, that is 60 divided by 3. Okay, and new average is 20. 20 will be printed here. Okay, and the while loop will again continue because the data is not equal to 0. Now, when the user prompts to enter a value, let us enter 0 now. Okay. And here, in the previous function call, the value of total became 60. The value of count was 3. Okay. And count plus plus, now count becomes 4. And total is equal to total plus d, that is 60 plus 0. Okay, is equal to 60. And now 60 divided by 4 is, I think 15 will be returned. Okay, so now the while loop will terminate. Because data is equal to 0, this condition became false. Okay, now let us see this program running actually. Enter a value, let's enter 10, average is equal to 10. Okay, again enter a value, let's enter 20. Now the average is 20 plus 10, 30 divided by 2 is equal to 50. Okay, new value 30, so the total became 60 now. 60 divided by 3 is equal to 20 is the new average. Now I enter 0, new average is 15. Okay. Now let us try to see what would happen if these total and count variables were normal variables, that is automatic variables. Okay, so we remove the static keyword from this definition of total and count. Okay, so now they are normal variables by default, so we do not need to write the keyword auto here. Because by default, all the variables are auto variables. Okay, so now let us try to see what will happen by running this program. Enter a value, I enter 10, suppose. Average is equal to 10, it is okay. Again, enter a value, now let us enter 20. Average is 20, so what is happening? Let's try to enter another value, 30, average is 30, another value, 40, average is 40. So average should not be 40. So let us try to see what are we getting. If I enter 0, the average is 0. So what is happening here is that suppose you enter 10 for the first time, then total will be initialized to 0. And count will be 0. Count plus plus, count will become 1. And total is equal to total plus d, that is 0 plus 10 is equal to 10. And return the average, that is 10 divided by 1. So it will return 10. It is okay, fine. And next time when the loop iterates, suppose I enter value 20. 20 is being passed, okay? But what is happening here? These total and count variables are created again. Why? Because these are the auto variables, and the auto variables which were created in the previous function call, they were deleted from the stack when this function was terminated. Okay, so again we are calling this function. Again, new variables will be created on the top of the stack, and they will be initialized to value 0. Okay, and count plus plus will make count 1, and total will now be total is equal to 0 plus 20, that is 20. Okay, and the average is 20 divided by 1, that is 20. That is why each time I call this function, it is giving me average by dividing the number by 1. So it is giving me the average for the current function call only. It is not taking into account the previous function calls. Why? Because the variables which we created in the previous function calls were deleted from the stack when the function was terminated. Okay?